IIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 8.
Hello children, how are you? I know you are very excited to hear me. In last episode we did many interesting and exciting things. We just saw riddles also. And you were ready with pen, notebook. You just noted down something. And I got responses also. You know, learning never ends. So, I welcome you in the second episode of Rational Numbers for class 8. Myself, Vinod Bala. I'll be your team member in today's class. Are you ready? I'm sure you are waiting. So let us start today's class, and I have a riddle for you also. I'm a 3-digit number. Listen carefully. I'm a 3-digit number. My unit's place is greater than 100th digit. My 10th digit is an even number. My double is more than 1000. Find me. Tell me which number am I? Let us try together. I'll also try. So in what way can we start? Tell me. You know, ideas rule the world. So in the beginning, we have to note down what things are given. In this riddle, I'm a 3-digit number. So we have to try with 3 digits. Then we have to follow the instructions. Next instruction is, its unit place is greater than 100th place. So we have to think for next instruction also. See, last line is, my double is more than 1000. So do we start with units place or 100th place? You are right. We are just going to start with 100th place. 100th place can be 1 or not? No, it cannot be. Because if 100th place is 1, then its double will not be more than 1000. Can we take 2 at 100th place? No, we cannot take 2 also. Then what? The possible digits which can be written at 100th place may be 5, 6, 7 or 8. There are 4 possibilities. Okay, let us try. Now, you are sure about 100th place? It can be either 5 or 6 or 7 or 8. Can you write 9? No. Why? Because if you will write 9 at 100th place, then you know units place should be more than 9. That is why you cannot take 9 at 100th place. Only there are 4 possibilities. Now, let us try by writing 3-digit numbers according to this riddle. The first number can be 526. Let us check whether all the conditions are satisfied or not. The very first condition is its double will be more than 1000. Then second condition is its unit's place is more than 100th place. The third condition is its 10th place is an even number. Do you think this is the only answer of this riddle? Okay, there can be many answers. Okay, with 5 at 100th digit, we can write 10th digit as 4 also, because the condition is only about even number. So the next number can be 546. 566 can also be there. 567 can be there. 569 can also be there. So in this way, you can just write many numbers. Try and just write. See children, if you are just taking 6 at 100th place, you can write down, because we decided about 4 possibilities. 100th place can be 5 or can be 6, can be 7 and can be 8. If you are writing 6 at 100th place, then 10th place you can leave for even numbers, and units place you have to take more than 6. The numbers can be 627, 628, 647, 648, etc. You can think. Similarly, you can take numbers with hundreds place as 7 and hundreds place as 8 also. Be careful, you cannot take 9. Was that interesting? I think you have enjoyed it. Let us start reflections of the previous episode. In the previous episode, we just talk about rational numbers and their properties. Do you know commutativity? Yes, I'm sure you know, because in the previous episode we just discuss about commutativity, associativity and closure property. Today we will apply these properties on rational numbers. Can you tell me the additive inverse of 19 upon minus 6? Think and tell me. What will you do? Okay, first you will write 19 upon minus 6 in standard form. That is minus 19 by 6. Now, let us think for its additive inverse. In additive inverse, we change the sign of the given rational number. According to that rule, the additive inverse of minus 19 by 6 will be 19 by 6. You can keep this rule in your mind by thinking that if the sum of two rational numbers is 0, then each one is known as additive inverse of the other. Okay, let us think for multiplicative inverse of 1 by 5. In last episode with these things. Can you tell me? Okay, you told me correct. You are just writing reciprocal of 1 by 5 and that is 5. Hence, multiplicative inverse of 1 by 5 is 5. Can you tell me such rational number whose multiplicative inverse does not exist? Think and tell me. Again, you have told me the correct answer. 0 is the only rational number whose multiplicative inverse does not exist. Why? Because reciprocal of 0 is 1 by 0 and which is not defined, because division by 0 is not possible. Now listen carefully. Tell me the name of the property under multiplication which is used in the following. You have to listen the statements carefully and you have to tell me the name of the property which is used in the given statement. Are you ready? Okay, the very first statement is, for two rational numbers, minus 5 by 7 and minus 7 by 2. Left hand side is minus 5 by 7 into minus 7 by 2 is equal to, now I'll tell you right hand side, minus 7 by 2 into minus 5 by 7. And if we simplify, we get the product 5 by 2. Just tell me the name of the property used here. Okay, it is commutativity. Yes, it is commutative property for the multiplication of rational numbers. You told me the correct answer. Now, listen carefully. I'll tell you the second statement. The second statement is minus 3 by 2 multiplied by 2 by minus 3 is equal to 1. What we call this property? Fine, multiplicative inverse. Very right. You are very smart children. Again, you told me the correct answer. Okay, listen the next statement carefully. Reciprocal of 1 by y is, fill in the blank. Tell me. Okay, that is y. You told me the correct answer. Reciprocal of 1 by y is y. If we are general rational numbers, in that case also we can think. Now, the next statement is, what will be the product of two rational numbers? Is it always a rational number or something else? Yes, it is always a rational number. Can you say about division also? Can you say the division of two rational numbers is always a rational number? No, we cannot say. Can you tell me why? We cannot say so because division by zero is not defined. That is why closure property is not held in the case of division. Can you tell me the natural numbers between 2 and 8? Yes, the natural numbers between 2 and 8 are 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, can you tell me integers also between minus 2 and 4? Yes, the integers are minus 1, 0, 1, 2 and 3. Exactly, you just answered correctly. Okay, let us talk about rational numbers. How many rational numbers are there between 7 by 10 and 13 by 10? Can you tell me? Okay, you need time to think. Okay, think. Let us think together. You may think of 8 by 10, 9 by 10, 10 by 10, 11 by 10, 12 by 10, etc. But if we write 7 by 10 in the form 70 by 100, because numerically these two numbers are equal. 7 by 10 and 70 by 100 are two equal rational numbers. And 13 by 10 can also be written in the form 130 by 100. Now, you may think of the rational numbers between 7 by 10 and 13 by 10 in the way 71 by 100, 72 by 100, 73 by 100 and so on. If further we extend, then 7 by 10 can be written in the form 700 by 1000 and 13 by 10 can also be written in the form 1300 by 1000. If we try to find the rational numbers between 7 by 10 and 13 by 10, then we can see 710 by 1000, 702 by 1000, 703 by 1000, 704 by 1000 and so on. Hence, there lie unlimited rational numbers between any two given rational numbers. Is it clear, children? Yes, you heard correctly. There lie unlimited rational numbers between any two given rational numbers. Now, we will try to find out various methods to find a rational number between given two rational numbers. Let us take the two given rational numbers as 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. How can you find it? Think and tell me. I just want to find out a rational number between 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. There are many ways. Let us try to think for these ways. The very first method is add these two rational numbers and divide by 2. Here, the given two rational numbers are 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. Let us add 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2 and divide the sum by 2. The sum of 1 by 4 and 1 by 2 is, by taking LCM, it will be 3 by 4 and divided by 2. It will be 3 by 8. Do you know 3 by 8 is the exact midpoint of the number line if 1 by 4 and 1 by 2 are marked on the number line. Naturally, it is a number that is 3 by 8 which lies between 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. Can you tell me some other method also? See, your ideas are also important. I just want to listen from you. Can you think for some other method? Okay, let us make the same denominators. The second method is we can make the same denominators. The same rational numbers we are just taking. 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. For 1 by 2, let us take the denominator 4. So this will be 2 by 4. 1 by 4 and 2 by 4. In between, we have 1.5. So we can find a rational number 1.5 by 4, which can be written as 15 by 40, and if we will convert it into lowest form, this will be 3 by 8. Now you may ask me, when there lie unlimited rational numbers between any two given rational numbers, then how can we think for the particular rational number which I told you, like 3 by 8 by the first method, by second method also? Very right answer. You have just asked a very relevant question. There lie unlimited, and you students can just give me different answers. There can be unlimited answers of this question, and your answers can be different from each other. But here we are just going to discuss about various methods. Till now I have shared two methods with you. There is third method also. Yes, you have correctly. Third method is converting the given rational numbers into decimal forms, and then easily you can find any number of rational numbers between these two. Like, I have taken two rational numbers, 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. Let me convert it into decimal forms. The decimal form of 1 by 4 is 0.25 and decimal form of 1 by 2 is 0.5. Now, between these two numbers, there lie again unlimited, but I have to find only one. Let me pick up 0.35. 0.35 lies between 0.25 and 0.5. But I have to reduce it into a rational number. 3.5 can be written as 35 by 10. And we are just going to reduce it in lowest form. So this will be 7 by 20. We can cancel the numerator and denominator by 5, and we can reduce it into lowest form. So these are different methods to find the rational numbers between any two. You may ask me another question, then which method is to follow? If a very less number of rational numbers are asked, like only 1, 2 or 3 rational numbers are asked between any two given rational number, simply we can apply the method, add the given rational numbers, divide by 2. You will get exactly the midpoint. Then you can take again any two numbers, again add those two and divide by 2. In this way, you can continue and you can find the rational numbers between given two rational numbers. But if 10 rational numbers are asked, 20 rational numbers are asked, 30, 100, large number of rational numbers are asked, I'll suggest you to make the common denominator of the given rational numbers, and then accordingly you can find the given number of rational numbers. If there is not any gap even after making the denominator, then you can multiply the numerator and denominator by 10 or by 100 or by 1000, and you can just find the required number of rational numbers. Another point to keep in the mind is numeric value of the given rational numbers should remain the same. You have to keep that in your mind. So you can decide easily by your own, out of these various methods, which method is easy for you and which method is time saving method, and in which method you are comfortable. Let us take one more example. Like, we can easily find 10 rational numbers between 5 by 7 and 9 by 7. Which method will you apply? We can find easily, that is not any problem. But I want to ask you, which method will you apply? Okay, since the denominators are same in 5 by 7 and 9 by 7. So 10 numbers, that is number is large. Multiply 5 by 7, the numerator and denominator both by 10. 5 by 7 will be numerically equal to 50 by 70. And 9 by 7 also, after multiplied by 10, will be numerically equal to 90 by 70. In both numbers, the denominator is again same, and easily you can find 10 rational numbers like 51 by 70, 52 by 70, 53 by 70, 54 by 70, 55 by 70, 56 by 70, 55 by 70, and so on. In this way, you can write down 10 rational numbers between given two rational numbers 5 by 7 and 9 by 7 easily. You can try to represent these numbers on the number line. Can you? Let us try. Now we are just talking about numbers on the number line. You are very comfortable with the number line. We have done in 7th and 6th classes also. And we just represented natural numbers on the number line, the line which extends indefinitely on the right of 1 in the case of natural numbers. We also know how to represent whole numbers on the number line. The line which extends indefinitely on the right but from 0. In the two cases, we know the difference also that in natural number, the line extends indefinitely on the right of 1, but in the case of whole numbers, it extends indefinitely to the right but from 0. There are no numbers on the left of 0 in the case of whole numbers. Did you notice one thing? That for whole numbers, the numbers start from 0 and 1. And did you notice anything to the left of 0? No. But what we call that set of numbers in which we have numbers on the left of 0 also. Do you have any guess? Yes, you told me correctly, that is the set of integers. In the case of integers, we have numbers to the left also. In integers, the line extends indefinitely on both sides and easily we can just mark 0 and positive integers on the right side like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and negative integers on the left of 0 also minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, etc. Did you see numbers between minus 1 and 0? You haven't seen? Okay, try to see. Mark small 10 divisions between 0 and minus 1 and think for the numeric value of each division. Try. Have you ever seen the numbers between 0 and 1? Again, you can mark as number of divisions as you like between 0 and 1 and you can just think for the numeric values. Between 1 and 2 also, there are many numbers. Yes, you can say between 0 and 1, the numbers like 1 by 5, 1 by 4, 1 by 3, 1 by 2, etc. And these are number, rational numbers on the number line. Children, keep your pencil and rulers ready to express rational numbers on the number line. Yes, keep your compass also ready because here we are just going to talk about equal parts also. I just suggested you to mark 10 parts between 0 and 1. But if you have taken a very small scale, it will be difficult for you. Just to make your work easy, you can take a small 10 divisions on the right of 0, equal divisions. And that can be marked as 1. And then you can think for numeric value of each division. When we have marked 10 equal divisions on the right of 0 and 10th division is written as 1, then each small division on the right of 0 can be written as 1 by 10, 2 by 10, 3 by 10, 4 by 10, 5 by 10, 6 by 10, 7 by 10, 8 by 10, 9 by 10 and 10 by 10 is obviously the 10th division that is equal to 1. Now let us think for 0 and 1 by 10. Between these two rational numbers again there lie unlimited rational numbers. So we can further take 10 divisions between 0 and 1 by 10, and we can just think for the numeric value of each division, like 1 by 100, 2 by 100, 3 by 100, 4 by 100. Like that, we can magnify and we can see. Again, there lie unlimited rational numbers between 0 and 1 by 100. So, this is the way to express rational numbers on the real line, on the number line. We can just try by our own. Now, it is time for us to see the reflections of today's class. What is done by us? We should just think for our listening skills and we should check. In the beginning, we thought of a riddle that was very interesting. Yes, I remember from the riddle. Today, at home, you can just prepare as many riddles as you like by your own. In the next class, you can ask me also the riddles. Then next, we revise the commutative property for rational numbers, for multiplication and for division, for addition also. We revised closure property, we revised associative property, and then we just revised few properties like additive inverse and multiplicative identity, etc. Today we just discussed various methods to find rational numbers between any two given rational numbers, and we planned also if the question is asked in different forms, then which method we have to apply. We developed understanding about that decision also. And the next was number line. Yes, we enjoyed number line. We revised natural numbers on the number line, then whole numbers, integers and rational numbers also. For you, the work is you have to practice to express rational numbers on the number line and make the riddles. I have brought a story for you. Are you surprised? And that too, a story in mathematics. As usual, this story also starts from the king. Actually, one maths teacher wrote this story because her son was fond of stories. In normal day-to-day routine, that teacher asks her son, "Okay, beta, come, let us start something interesting and let us do the homework." The child came with the Hindi book. Then this teacher asked, "Why not maths book?" He said, "In maths book, there are not any stories. You are maths ma'am. So why don't you write some stories in mathematics?" This teacher tried and wrote the story. There was a king. He used to donate wealth, coins, rupees, land to the various people who used to come to the kingdom. And the wise minister, he used to save one or the other thing by using his mathematical ideas. One day, one poet came and he recited a poem to praise the king. The king was very happy. He called the minister and asked him to give a piece of land whose area is 100 by 100 meter square. That is 10,000 meter square. The minister said, "Okay," and he accompanied the poet. The poet and the minister were going. On the way, the minister asked the poet, "How many kids have you?" The poet replied, 4. Then the minister planned something and asked the poet, "Okay, dear poet, can I give you 4 plots, each of size 25 by 25, instead of a single plot of size 100 by 100 meters?" The poet said, "Yes, you can give me 4 because I have 4 kids." In this way, the minister calculated the area for one plot of size 25 by 25. It was 625 meters squares, and since there were 4 plots, so the total area of 4 plots was 625 into 4, that is 2500 meters square. He was supposed to give 10,000 meters squares, but He just gave only 2,500 meters square and saved 7,500 meters squares. He just gave 1/4 and saved 3/4. In this way, he was just applying his mathematical ideas in day-to-day life and he was making everyone happy and he was saying, yes, ideas rule the world. Did you enjoy the story? Okay, it's time to say goodbye. Thank you for listening patiently. In the next episode, I'll be having something very exciting for you. Thank you. Good day.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta, and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.